Today's lecture, we will start with the problem on tensile bar. So, this is the problem. A tensile bar of length. So, length is given. That is, first geometrical parameter is given. The length of the bar is given as 400 mm. A tensile bar of length 400 mm is subjected to constant tensile force. So, second also parameter given, that is tensile force. So, this tensile force is your functional requirement parameter. And it is also given, that is specified. So, a tensile bar of length, length is your geometrical parameter. And it is also specified, that is 400 mm. And is subjected to a constant tensile force of 3000 Newton. So, a tensile force is given, that is this force parameter, it is also specified. Again, if factor of safety is 2, so factor of safety, it is again a functional requirement parameter and it is also specified. So, this is a factor of safety is given 2. Now, we have to design a bar parameter or bar using Johnson method with objective. Now, objective is given in the problem. So, with objective that we have to minimize the material weight. We have to minimize the material weight using following optimum design material. So, the table of optimum design material is given. So, in first column there is material, second column density, that is kg per meter cube, cost RS per kg, that is rupees per kg, and yield tensile strength is given, that is Newton per mm square. So, first material is given steel, having density 7800, cost 28 rupees, and SYT, that is 400 Newton per mm square. Then again, second material, aluminium alloy, having density 2800 kg per meter cube, cost is given 132 rupees per kg, and SYT, that is yield tensile strength, is given 150 Newton per mm square. And third material is given titanium alloy, having density 4500, cost 2200, and SYT, that is 800. So, this is your problem. So, we will take today one problem, that is minimizing the weight. Same problem we will take in tomorrow with minimizing the cost. Same. Only objective is changes, or objective will be changed. So, a tensile bar of a length 400 mm is subjected to constant tensile force of 3000 Newton. If factor of safety is 2, design the bar parameters using Johnson method with objectives of minimizing the material weight using following optimum design material. So, there is a table given and all that. There are materials, three materials are given, that is steel, aluminum and alloy, steel, aluminum alloy and titanium alloy, with density, cost and yield strength of each material is given. So, this is the problem. Now, this problem is generally asked for 10 to 14 marks. 10 to 14 marks. So, this problem is asked generally up to 10 to 14 marks. So our first, what is Johnson method? In Johnson method, the first step was we have to select geometrical parameter. Now, geometrical parameter is given already. So, length is given as a geometrical parameter. Second step, we have to decide the objective, that is the objective of the optimum design or basis of the optimum design. Also, the problem mentions there is an objective. What is the objective? We have to minimize the weight. So, third step, that is our first step, it is nothing but the, what is that third step? That is, we have to write the primary design equation. So, we have to write a primary design equation. Now, primary design equation, it is only one equation. There are not more than one equation required in case of primary design equation. Now, for example, there is a bar. So, bar is given having some diameter. So, let this is a bar. So, bar having a diameter D. Then, length of bar. So, L is the length of bar. And the constant tensile force, it is acting on bar, it is say F. So, F is the constant tensile force which is acting on a bar having diameter small d and length L. So, weight, what is weight? Weight is nothing but the your density into volume, density into volume, that is actually this density is weight density, that is rho into g, and volume is your v. Now volume is nothing but the area into length, bar asel tar it is area into length. So this is weight density, that is rho g, and the volume is nothing but the area into length. So area is denoted by a, that is cross sectional area of the bar, and L is your length of the bar. So, rho g is same. Now, what is the cross sectional area of the bar? The cross sectional area of the bar is pi by 4 d square L. Cross sectional area is pi by 4 d square, and that L is same. So, our primary design equation is rho into g pi by 4 d square L. And is a simplified equation by yourself. So, our simplified equation is rho g a l. So this is your primary design equation which represent the objective of the problem. Now what is objective? To minimize the weight. So w is your weight. So this is your primary design equation. Now next step is we have to write all subsidiary design equation and limit equation. Now subsidiary design equation, it is nothing but the other than primary design equation. Now because of force, there is there will be a stress developed, and that stress equation, it is your subsidiary design equation. Now what is stress? Now there is tensile force, so there will be a tensile stress, or we can say tensile stress sigma t is nothing but the force per unit area, that is F upon A. So this is your subsidiary design equation. Now in this problem, there is only one subsidiary design equation. There is no other subsidiary design equation. Now next one is limit equation. Now there is one parameter given is limited parameter, specified but limited. That is stress is limited parameter because the tensile state, it should not be greater than SYT upon factor of safety. That is, tensile stress, it should be less than or equal to, maximally it equals to, or it should be less than the SYT upon factor of safety. So, this is your limit equation. So, in that problem also, there is only one limit equation. Now, in this problem, there is only one primary design equation. There is only one subsidiary design equation and there is only one limit equation. But in other problem, there may be a more than one subsidiary design equation and more than one limit equation. So this is, we have to write primary design equation, then we have write subsidiary design equation, and then we have write limit equation. Now next step is we have to write classification of parameter. Now we have to draw a table. In that table, the classification of parameter table. Now in that, there are four parameter, that is your functional requirement parameter. So this is first. Second parameter is your undesirable effect parameter. Third parameter is your geometrical parameter. And fourth parameter is your material parameter. So these all are parameters, that is functional requirement, undesirable effect, geometrical and material parameter. And on the basis, they are classified into specified, limited, unspecified, unlimited. So they are classified into these three categories: specified, limited parameter, unspecified, unlimited. Now we have the parameters, like in primary design equation, we have these parameters, that is rho, g, a, l. Now this rho is your material parameter, g is constant. Then a and l, these both are geometrical parameters. So this is, these are the parameters we have to classify. Next is force. Now area already covered, and sigma t. So force is your functional requirement, and sigma t is your undesirable effect parameter. Again, in limit equation, sigma t is covered, SYT is your material parameter, and factor of safety is your functional requirement parameter. And this factor of safety, that is functional requirement parameter, it is given. Now we have to classify these parameters. So rho is your first parameter, g constant, it cannot be taken. Area is your second, length third parameter, force fourth, sigma t fifth, then SYT sixth, and factor of safety seventh. This seventh parameter we have to classify. So density, density of all material is given in table, so it is specified, but it is material parameter. So all these material parameter are specified. So this all material parameter, that is given in table, but we require only two parameter, that is density and SYT. The cost is not required for this problem, because we have to not minimize the cost. So only two parameter required, that is rho and SYT. So two parameter is given, completed, that is density is completed and your SYT is completed. Now next parameter, area. Now area is geometrical parameter, but it is unspecified, unlimited, because it is not given also and it is not limited also. Next parameter is length. Length is specified in the problem, that is given in the problem, but it is limited. It should be L should be in specified, because length is given. L is in this specified, but it geometrical parameter. So there are two geometrical parameter, that is area, which is unspecified, unlimited, and length, which is specified. Next parameter is your sigma t, which is undesirable effect parameter, but sigma t is limited because it is used in limit equation also. So this is limited parameter. Again, undesirable effect parameter is your weight, and this weight, it is also in unlimited and unspecified, that is not limited, that is not specified also, and that is not limited also. And we having functional requirement parameter, that is force. Without force we cannot function that bar, and factor of safety. So these two are the functional requirement parameter, and these both, force and factor of safety, both are given in the problem, so it is specified. So this is the classification of parameters, that is into functional requirement, undesirable effect, geometrical, material parameter. They are classified into specified, limited, unspecified, unlimited. The force and factor of safety is specified, and functional requirement parameter, undesirable effect parameter, that is sigma t, which is limited, and weight, which is unspecified, unlimited. Geometrical parameter, length is specified, and area is unspecified, unlimited, and material parameter, which is given in material, that is density and SYT. So this is your classification of parameter is given in the problem. So this is your fourth method or fourth step. Next is fifth step, that is combine SDE with PDE. Now what is the equation for PDE, that is rho A G and L. And what is the subsidiary design equation? That is sigma T is equals to F by A. Now, in both equation, if we consider, so in primary design equation, there is common factor, that is common material factor, geometrical factor area. And in this also, there is common factor area. So we have to eliminate this common factor in primary design equation and in secondary design. So secondary design equation, we can write area is nothing but the, now sigma T is nothing but the force upon area. So we can write area is nothing but the force upon sigma T. So force upon sigma T. So what is your primary design equation? Rho A G L. So we have to replace this A by force upon sigma T, that is F upon sigma T. So what is your equation? So W is equals to rho G, area is replaced, that is F upon sigma T, and L same as it is. So we get a equation rho G F L upon sigma T. So this is combined SDE with PDE. Now we have to combine limit equation with primary design equation. Now what is limit equation? Sigma T is equals to SYT upon NF. So we have to replace this sigma T by SYT upon NF. So from that, rho is depends on material, G is constant. Again NF, it is given, force it is given, length it is given, and SYT, it is depends on material. So rho upon SYT we have to taken outside, and all other parameters are specified in the problem. That is G is your 9.81, then factor of safety is 2, then force is 3000, and your length is 400 mm given, that is 0.4 meter. So we have to combine that and we get a, that is developed primary design equation as W is equals to, if we put all the values on that, so we get that constant factor is 23544 and rho upon SYT. Now rho upon SYT is depends upon material. Now we have to minimize this value, that is we have to minimize the weight. So this material selection value, that is rho upon SYT, it is called as material selection value. So we have to take this material selection value as minimum so as to minimize the weight. We have to take material selection value minimum so as to minimize the weight. So our next step is, that is selection of material. Now material are given, that is steel, aluminium alloy, titanium alloy, again density is given and SYT given. So next is material selection factor. Now what is material selection factor? Rho upon SYT. So this is material selection factor. Now density is given, kg per meter cube. Now SYT is given, newton per mm square. Now mm square cha aplyala meter square madhe karay lagel, newton per meter square. So we are required a factor of 10 raised to minus 6, sorry, into meter madhe 10 raised to 6, and rho upon SYT madhe kelyanantar it is comes to be 10 raised to minus 6, because SYT is in dividation. So when we use newton per mm square, we have to convert into newton per meter square, then we have to multiply by 10 raised to 6, and when it is dividation, the factor is 10 raised to minus 6. So 7800 upon 400, it is 19.5. 2800 upon 150, it is 18.67, and 4500 upon 800, it is 5.625. So we have to select the material having minimum material selection factor. So minimum it is 5.625. So we have to select the material, that is material to be selected is titanium alloy with material selection factor rho upon SYT is 5.625 into 10 raised to minus 6. So this is all about your material selection, that is selection of material. Now next is we have to determine the eliminated parameter. So we have to determine the eliminated parameter, and your eliminated parameter is area, because area is limit eliminated. So sigma t is equals to F upon A. Now what is sigma t? SYT upon factor of safety. Now material is selected, that is titanium alloy. So that's a factor of safety, that's a SYT, that is yield tensile strength is 800, factor of safety is 2, force is 300. So the area coming up to, that is 7.5 mm square. This is your area. Now high mm madhe ka ala, because your SYT is taken in Newton per mm square. So SYT is your Newton per mm square. So your area is also in mm square, and that area is come to be 7.5. And our last, that is minimum material weight. So this minimum material weight, it is your, so our this constant factor, that is 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, and material selection factor, that is rho upon SYT. So what is value of rho upon SYT? It is 5.625 into 10 raised to minus 6. So our weight comes to be 0.132 Newton. So this is all about the problem, that is the our problem was we have to design a tensile bar of length 400 mm subjected to constant tensile force 3000 Newton. If factor of safety is 2, we have to design the bar parameter. Bar parameter is nothing but the area. Now we can find out the area, from that area we can find out the diameter also. And what is your objective? Objective is minimizing the weight, and the material are given. So first step was we have to design primary design equation. Second step was your subsidiary design equation. Third step, limit equation. Fourth step, classification of all these parameters. Fifth, combine subsidiary design equation with primary design equation. Again, combine limit equation with primary design equation. Then selection of the material. We have to select this material. And next is we have to eliminate the parameter. So we have to determine eliminated parameter, that is area. And from that we can find out the weight. Now in notes, there is wrongly written, that is 10 raised to minus 3. It is 10 raised to minus 6. So because of that, the answer of weight, it is 0.132 Newton. It is 10 raised to, not 10 raised to minus 3, it is 10 raised to minus 6. So